Afternoon friends, we have learned about the mechanical process in the digestion process part of the digestive system of humans. So let's start today about chemical process. The chemical process involves various biochemical reactions in which various kinds of enzymes are involved. The first process starts at the mouth where we eat the food. The food when enters in mouth, it is mixed with salivary amylase and near about 30% of the starch and other carbohydrates are start to digest in the mouth only. The salivary amylase enzyme works at pH 6.8. It converts the starch into maltose. Then the second process starts in the stomach. The stomach mucosa contains three types of cells. These three kinds of cells are, the first kinds of cells are neck cells, which secrete mucus. Second kinds of cells are known as peptic cells or chief cells, which secrete proenzyme pepsinogen. And third kinds of cells in the stomach mucosa are parietal or oxyntic cells, which secrete HCl in stomach at pH 1.8, an intrinsic factor. This intrinsic factor is responsible for absorption of vitamin B12 in the stomach. Next, the stomach stores the food for 4 to 5 hours and secretes gastric juice, which is in the form of chyme, mixture of various enzymes. It also contains small amounts of lipases also. Next kind of secretions are the bile, pancreatic juice and intestinal juice. These are released into small intestine. Pancreatic juice and bile are released through hepatopancreatic duct, a common duct where liver secretions and the pancreatic secretions are released into small intestine commonly. Then the pancreatic juice, what does it contain? It contains inactive enzymes. These inactive enzymes are trypsinogen, chemotrypsinogen, procarboxypeptidases, which are a kind of proteases, which digest protein into dipeptides and later into amino acids. These also contains amylases, lipases, nucleases. Amylases are responsible for digestion of starch. Lipases are responsible for digestion of lipids or fats. Nucleases are responsible for digestion of nucleic acids into nucleotides and further into nucleosides. The intestinal mucosal goblet cells secrete succus entericus mucus, which also releases these three kinds of enzymes: proteases, amylases, nucleases, etc. etc. In gallbladder secretions of liver, there are several pigments and several kinds of biochemicals released into the duodenum part along with pancreatic juice through same duct, hepatopancreatic duct. These are bile pigments, which are bilirubin and biliverdin, bile salts, cholesterol, phospholipids, but no enzyme secretion is released from gallbladder. The enzymes are released only from the pancreatic juice and the intestinal mucosa and the stomach in the previous part. So let's see about the next thing, how these are digested. Starch is digested into disaccharides. Disaccharides are digested into monosaccharides and they enter into the metabolic pathway of catabolism to generate ATP. Next, how these second kind of things are digested? Proteins. Proteins are digested by using proteases such as trypsin, chemotrypsin, carboxypeptidases. These convert proteins, peptone and protease into dipeptides and dipeptides are further converted to amino acids. Fats are also converted into diglycerides with the help of enzymes lipases, then further into monoglycerides.